The Boeing 787 Dreamliner involves many innovations in design and construction and has a number of different features compared to other Boeing jets. One of these is how its engine bleed air system works. Traditionally, jet aircraft make extensive use of bleed air from the engines to operate other systems. This makes sense, but with improvements in electrical options and other technology, it is no longer the most efficient option. With this in mind, Boeing has redesigned these systems on the 787 to use more electrical power. So what do you need to know about Boeing's no-bleed architecture on its 787 Dreamliners? Let's explore this for today's video. Did you know that the Boeing 787 was the first Boeing jet to feature a no-bleed design? This was a major departure from previous models, as almost all aircraft use engine bleed air in many areas. So what exactly is bleed air? Well, this is air that is taken from the main engine airstream to use for pressurization and other functions. These include cabin pressurization and air conditioning, anti-icing functions on the wings and other surfaces, APU function and engine starting, and various hydraulic and pneumatic systems. As you can see, engine bleed air can do a lot. Boeing designed the Boeing 787 Dreamliner differently, though. For the first time, the manufacturer made use of improvements in technology and electrical systems to design an alternative to the bleed air system. Instead, many systems, but not all, operate using electrical power. The 787 stands alone with this for the time being. Airbus has not used the no-bleed design for the A350. Interestingly, Boeing has also decided not to include it in the design of the upcoming Boeing 777X. Boeing's design for the 787 results in less complexity and cost of the engine. The no-bleed architecture introduced on the Boeing 787 aims to reduce the use of engine bleed air significantly. Bleed air is still needed in some areas, including engine cowl ice protection and the pressurization of hydraulic reservoirs. But exactly which bleed systems were replaced with electrical ones? As much as possible has been designed to operate using electrical power. The 787 uses electric power generated by four engine-mounted generators and two auxiliary power units. The electrical systems include 1. An electrothermal wing anti-ice system. This uses electrical impulses to protect the wing from accumulating ice. Boeing states that the power usage of the wing anti-ice system on the 787 is half that of the pneumatic system. 2. Replacement of many hydraulic and pneumatic systems with electrical systems. 3. Engine starting systems. 4. Cabin environment and pressurization, and 5. Powering high-capacity hydraulic pump systems. With this, many components, including manifolds, valves, and fittings, can be removed from the aircraft engines. This reduced engine complexity, weight, and with it, reduced cost. The greatest advantage of no bleed is improved efficiency. The traditional bleed system used on most jets consumes a lot of useful energy generated by the engines. The need to use air for many other functions increases fuel use and reduces overall engine efficiency. This was a major consideration in the design of the Boeing 787. According to Boeing, the 787's bleedless architecture extracts as much as 35% lower engine power than the conventional systems, and the overall fuel savings sits at around 3%. Other factors also feed into improved efficiency, including the lower weight of the engines and lower weight of various hydraulic and pneumatic components. In fact, Boeing claims, for example, that hundreds of pounds of weight is saved by removing titanium ducting normally used to pass pressurized air around the aircraft. The new electrical systems also save the waste of excess energy from the bleed air that is dumped after usage. Reducing the high pressure of air taken off the engine is also wasteful. Mike Sinnett, director of Boeing 787 Systems, explained this design reasoning, saying, One of the advantages of the no-bleed electrical system's architecture is the greater efficiency gained in terms of reduced fuel burn. The 787 system's architecture accounts for predicted fuel savings of about 3%. The 787 also offers operators operational efficiencies due to the advantages of electrical systems compared to pneumatic systems in terms of weight and reduced life cycle costs. Our fourth point has to do with big changes to the aircraft's hydraulic systems. Bleed air is still used, but electrical addition makes the systems more efficient. Hydraulic systems are particularly important, and the 787 makes some big changes. Hydraulics are used in all large aircraft to operate or move many systems, including control surfaces and flaps, the landing gear and nose gear, and thrust reversers. The basic idea behind hydraulics is to transfer an input from the pilot to the required forceful output to make the required movement. This is either done manually or mechanically, or in the case of fly-by-wire systems, electronically. Whatever the input may be, it is physically performed using pressurized hydraulic systems. Traditionally, up to three separate hydraulic systems are pressurized using bleed air. On the 787, the hydraulic system has been redesigned to use electric power. Bleed air is still used for some of the pressurization of hydraulic reservoirs, one of the main areas where bleed air is used. In particular, the 787 maintains three hydraulic systems, left, right, and central, each pressurized separately. The left and right hydraulic systems are driven by engine-driven pumps as normal, with an additional electric pump for peak demand and ground use. The central system is driven by two large electric pumps with no engine-driven pumps. And the electric pumps provide higher pressure, 5,000 psi rather than 3,000 psi in traditional systems. This allows for smaller hydraulic components, further saving on weight. Our final point on this topic is that this no-bleed design also offers operational improvements. The aircraft's range is increased and maintenance is simplified. The lower weight and reduced fuel consumption both add to the range that the aircraft can achieve. Another advantage claimed by Boeing is reduced maintenance. The bleed system is very high maintenance, and so with the 787's design, things are simplified with fewer parts. This is not entirely clear, though, with some commentators warning that electrical systems bring different maintenance challenges. What do you think of this design for the Boeing 787 Dreamliner? Do you think we might see this on more aircraft in the future? Let us know your thoughts by leaving a comment down below. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.